Hello friends, welcome to the Knowledge Club Online. It's a very important lesson, chapter. It's a pedigree. Pedigree analysis. A pedigree is a family tree or chart made of symbols and lines that represents a person's genetic family history. In pedigree, symbols represent people and lines represents a genetic relationship. The pedigree is a visual tool for documenting the biological relationship in families and determining the mode of inheritance, dominant, recessive, etc. on genetic diseases. Pedigrees are most often constructed by medical genetics or genetic counselors. A sample pedigree, a tool that can be used to trace genetic traits or diseases without several generations, show actual results. The key is male, female, affected individual, parent and parents and one child, these twins. This is an example of and pedigree. Pedigree symbols. This is a male, female. This is an individual with a condition. This is a carrier status in females, extreme condition. This is a diseased. Indigenous person, also individual through whom family is accelerated. Individual without children. Recessive gene carrier. Sex unknown. Miscarriage. Relationship 1, 2, 3, generation number. This is a marriage, de facto, marriage or relationship ended, second marriage or relationship, the twins are non-identical, consensually closely related parents, partners, adoption out of a family, adoption into a family, a father and mother with one son and two daughters. This is also an example of the pedigree. The pedigree of a family afflicted with a neurofibromatosis, and autosomal dominant genetic disorder. Inheritance patterns in pedigrees. X-linked dominant and X-linked recessive and Y-linked. The autosomal dominant inheritance, the trait should not keep generations, and affected persons mating with an unaffected person should produce approximately 50% affected offspring, indicating also that the affected individual is heterozygous. The distribution of the trait among sexes should be almost equal, transmitted by either sex. This is an example of autosomal dominant. The black one is affected and another one is unaffected. Every affected person should have at least one affected parent. The males and females should be equally often affected, and affected person have at least a 50% chance of the transmitting the dominant allele to each offspring. This is an example of progeria caused by a mutation in which the person ages very rapidly. They die before they can reproduce. Huntington disease, in which the central nervous system starts to break down around the age of 30. Now the autosomal recessive inheritance. The trait often skips generations, and almost equal number of affected males and females. If both parents are affected, all children should be affected. In most cases of unaffected people mating with affected individuals, all children produced are unaffected. When at least one child is affected, indicating that the unaffected person parent is heterozygous, then approximately half the children should be affected. Most affected individuals have unaffected parents. This is the autosomal recessive. clear the prokaryote. Two affected parents will have affected children 100% of the time. Example of autosomal recessive disease, the albinism in a genetic condition which is the loss of pigment in hair, skin and eyes. TSH is a genetic disorder which is a buildup of fatty depositions in the brain, eventually proving to be fatal. Condominant inheritance, sickle cell anemia is a condominant conditions disorder in which there is a defect in hemoglobin, an important protein in red blood cells. An individual homozygous for sickle cell suffers from blood clots, anemia, and usually dies prematurely. An individual heterozygous for normal and sickle cells does not suffer the full disorders, but some red blood cells still have defective hemoglobin. In certain areas of the world, this is an advantage. Malaria is caused by a protist that prefers normal blood cells. If some of your blood cells are damaged, you are less likely to become a host. Heterozygous advantage. Now, the X-linked recessive inheritance refers to those most affected individuals are male. Affected males result from mothers who are affected or who are known to be carrier, heterozygous. Affected females come from affected father and affected or carrier mothers. The sons of affected females should be affected. Approximately half the sons of carrier should be affected. This is the example of X-linked recessive inheritance. The X-linked recessive disorders are hemophilia, which is the inability of the blood to clot properly, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, which causes a progressive and degenerative muscle weakness. Now, the X-linked dominant inheritance. The trait does not skip generations. Affected males must come from affected mothers. Approximately half the children of an affected heterozygous male are affected. Affected females come from affected mother or father. All the daughters but none of the sons of an affected father are affected. This is the example of link dominant inheritance. This is the vitamin D resistant rickets, which can lead to bone deformities, particularly in the lower limbs. Another one is a Y-linked inheritance, affects only males. Affected males always have an affected father. All sons of an affected man are affected. Tips for solving pedigree. You must figure out two things in order to correctly solve a problem involving a pedigree. Determine if a trait is dominant or recessive. Determine if trait is autosomal or sex-linked. This is a pedigree chart showing genetic relationship between members of a family. Squares represent males, circle females, color shows an infected person, half shaded shows carrier. Now try it out. This lecture may be helpful to you. Thank you.